Hi guys, welcome to my channel. In this channel, we provide the in-depth knowledge of different programming languages like C, C++, Java, Python, etc., which differentiate you with others. In our series of Python for Class 12, we have already uploaded 4 lectures. Today we are uploading 5th lecture. Today we will discuss how to evaluate relational expression, how to evaluate logical expression, what is the precedence of the operators, and what is typecasting. So let's start, try to concentrate, but we are teaching. In the last class, we have already discussed how to evaluate an arithmetic expression. Today we are discussing evaluating relational expression. Let's start. All comparison operations in Python have the same priority, as we have discussed in the last class. Whenever an expression is evaluated or solved, the operator works according to the precedence or the priority that a Python provides to that operator. Getting my point? Means the operator enjoying the higher priority or precedence will be solved before than the operator enjoying the lower priority, and if two operators are enjoying the same priority, then associativity comes into scene. It may be left to right or right to left. One more point that we have discussed, we cannot change the precedence or the priority of an operator at any cost, as well as the associativity of an operator. So we have to solve the problem according to the precedence that is provided by the Python language. So today we will see how to evaluate relational expression. All comparison operations in Python have the same priority, which is lower than that of any arithmetic operation. Means if in any expression there is a relational operator and an arithmetic operator, first arithmetic operator will be solved, then only relational operator will be solved. All relation expression yields Boolean value only, that is true or false. No doubt. Relational operator means less than, greater than, less than equal to, greater than equal to, equal to, equal to, not equal to. This comes under relational operator. They always gives result in true or false. Is 10 is less than 20? The answer will be what? Either true or false. If is A is equal to B, means kya A ki value B ke barabar hai, then what? Answer will be ya to hai, ya to nahi hai, ya to true, ya to false. That is why what we have written, all the relational expression yield Boolean value only, that is true or false. Let's take an example. How would following relational expression will be solved? P is greater than Q and less than Y. First, P is greater than Q will be solved, and Q is less than Y will be solved. If both the condition will be true, answer will be true. Same thing, A is less than or equal to N, or n is less than or equal to b. So answer will be a. First a is less than or equal to n will be compared, and n is less than or equal to b will be compared. What will be the answer? That will be displayed or written. So this is how we can evaluate the relational expression. Basically here we have to see the all the relation expression yield Boolean value, that is true or false. The relational operator always written either true or false depending upon the parameters or the operands. Getting my point? Next is evaluating logical expressions. Logical operator means AND, NOT. This all are what? Logical operators. Usually the operands of this operator is a condition. Usually, I am not saying it is always. Usually, suppose there is an expression, is 10 is less than 20 and 20 is greater than 40. So here AND is what? AND is a logical operator, and 10 is less than 20 and 20 is less than 30 is what? These are the operands of AND. So these are conditions. Usually, I am not saying always, usually the operands of an logical operator is always condition. While evaluating logical expression, Python follows certain rules that we have already discussed. Let's discuss once again. The precedence of the logical is lower than the arithmetic operators. same as in the case of relational operator. So arithmetic sub expression, if any, is evaluated first, then logical operators are applied, like 25 divided by 5 or 2.0 plus 20 divided by 10. Now in this expression we are having one logical R or and three arithmetic operators, two division and one positive. So how it will be solved? First 25 divided by 5 will be solved, answer will be 5, or then 20 divided by 10, answer will be 2, then 2 plus 2.0, answer will be 4.0, so 5 or 4.0, answer will be 5. Getting my point? See how it's working. First, this 25 by 5 will be solved, answer is 5. Then 20 divided by 10, answer will be 2. 2 plus 2.0, that is 4.0. So 5 or 4.0, answer will be 5. So if an expression is having logical as well as arithmetic operators, first arithmetic operators are solved, then logical operators are solved. Why? Because the precedence of the arithmetic operators is higher than the logical operators. Getting my point? Next, another point, the precedence of the logical operators among themselves is not and or. So the expression A or B and not C will be evaluated as A or B and not of C. The first not of C will be solved. Let's take an example, print 10 or 20 and not 30. How this expression will be solved? See, first not of 30 is what? Not of 30 means 30 is true, not of 30 is false. So answer is false here, and false hai. So 20 and it will not check 20. So answer will be 10. These operators are also known as short circuit operators. Short circuit operator means if left hand side operands gives the result, it will not check for the right hand side. Means agar left hand side operand check karke ye decide ho jata hai ki ye condition aapki true hogi ki false hogi, it will not check for the right hand side. Like suppose if we are using AND, if this condition is true, so this may be false, so compiler has to check. If this condition is false, ab ye true ho ya false ho, ye total will be false, so compiler will not check this. Same thing if you are using OR, if it is false, so it may be chance this condition will be true or this operand will be true, so compiler have to check it. And if it is true, whether it's a true or false, the answer of this will be true, so it will not check for the right hand side. Getting my point? See here. While evaluating Python, minimize internal work by following these rules. In OR evaluation, Python only evaluates the second argument if first one is false. Agar first one false hogi, tabhi ho jaake dusri आर्ग्यूमेंट को चेक करेगा, अदरवाइज इट विल इग्नोर. इन एंड इवेल्यूएशन पाइथन ओनली इवेल्यूएट द सेकंड आर्ग्यूमेंट इफ फर्स्ट वन इज ट्रू, क्योंकि सेकंड वाला फॉल्स हो सकता है. तो एंड मीन्स बोथ द कंडीशन शुड बी ट्रू, और मीन्स आइदर वन विल बी ट्रू. तो अगर लेफ्ट हैंड साइड से ये कंडीशन चेक हो जाती है कि टोटल इसका आंसर ट्रू और फॉल्स आने वाला है, तो इट विल नॉट चेक फॉर द राइट हैंड साइड. दैट इज वाई दिस इज नोन एज शॉर्ट सर्किट ऑपरेटर. वो वहीं से क्या हो जाते हैं, शॉर्ट सर्किट हो जाते हैं. Similarly, P and Q or not R will be always as P and Q or not of R. Not of R means 30 matlab true, not of 30 means false. Ab ye false hai, to isko check karega, to iska answer ye 20, 20 yani true. True or false, answer will be true. Aur ye AND hai, to answer will be 20. Getting my point? Same thing. 10 and 0 or not of 30. Not of 30 means 0, 0 or 0, 0. 10 and 0 is false. Why? Because right hand side operand is 0. So we are getting false. यू चेक आउट इन योर कंपाइलर, थोड़ा थोड़ा प्रैक्टिस कीजिए आप, क्योंकि ऑन द फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट डे आई एम सेइंग दिस कंप्यूटर इज अ प्रैक्टिकल ओरिएंटेड सब्जेक्ट. जैसे आई हैव गिवन एन एग्जाम्पल प्रिंट 10 एंड 20 और नॉट 30, तो ट्राई टू रिमूव 30 वॉट यू आर गेटिंग, ट्राई टू यूज और इन प्लेस ऑफ एंड वॉट यू आर गेटिंग. तो एटलीस्ट यू शुड ट्राई 4-5 एग्जाम्पल्स. इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट बॉक्स, आई विल ट्राई टू रिप्लाई द आंसर टू एवरी क्वेश्चन. गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? सो while evaluating python minimize internal work by following these rules, means if left hand side operands gives the result it will not check for the right hand side, that is why these operators are known as short circuit operators. Another example, 5 is less than 10 and 10 is less than 5, or 3 is less than 18 and not 8 is less than 18. Now 8 is less than 18 means what? 8 is less than 8, true. Not of true is false, and के इधर false होगा तो it will not check this. तो इसका पूरे का आंसर क्या आ जाएगा? False. क्योंकि अब ये true हो या false हो, इस पूरे का आंसर क्या आना है? False. और 10 is less than 5 is what? False. False और false. False. अब अगर ये यहाँ पे ये पूरे का आंसर क्या आना होगा? False. अब ये condition true भी होगी, then least bother. Why? Because this is false. False and true. And means वो should be true. तो अगर एक false है तो it will not check for this. तो answer will be false. Okay, go through this. If any doubt, you can ask me. This is a operator precedence table. This cannot be changed. Means if any expression is having exponential and then multiplication, first exponential will be solved and then multiplication will be solved. Means this is your highest and this is your lowest. So you have to remember this. वो धीरे धीरे प्रोग्रामिंग करते रहोगे तो ये रिमेंबर करने की जरूरत नहीं, ऑलरेडी ये सारी चीजें प्रैक्टिस में आ जाती है. इफ यू आर हैविंग दिस एस्ट्रिक डिवीजन, फ्लोर डिवीजन, रिमाइंडर and plus minus, the first multiplication, division, float division and remainder will be solved, then addition and subtraction will be solved, then relational operator, then logical operator. Getting my point? Means the operators which are enjoying the higher priority, the sabse pehle kya hoga? Parenthesis. Means if I write like this, if I am having an expression, how this parenthesis work? If I am writing like this, a प्लस बी डिवाइड बाई थ्री. नाउ रूल के सॉरी रूल के हिसाब से फर्स्ट बी डिवाइडेड बाई थ्री विल बी डन. वाई? बिकॉज डिविजन इज हैविंग हायर प्रायोरिटी देन एडिशन. बट अवर प्रोग्राम लॉजिक से या अवर प्रोग्राम रिक्वायरमेंट से फर्स्ट एडिशन शुड बी डन देन डिविजन शुड बी डन. देन वी कैनॉट चेंज द प्रायोरिटी ना. तो वट आई विल डू, आई विल पुट वन पैरेंथिसिस हियर. तो फर्स्ट ए प्लस बी विल बी देयर, जो भी इसका आंसर आएगा देन 20 डिवाइडेड बाई 3 विल बी देयर. सपोज ए एंड बी आर हैविंग 10, दैट इज व्हाई पैरेंथेसिस इज हैविंग हाईएस्ट प्रायोरिटी. ओके, गो थ्रू दिस. इफ एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क मी. नेक्स्ट वन इज टाइप कास्टिंग, और यू कैन से एक्सप्लिसिट टाइप कास्टिंग, बिकॉज इम्प्लिसिटली तो अपने आप ही कर लेता है टू द हायर एंड. सपोज अगर आपका इंट और फ्लोट है तो इट विल अपकास्ट टू फ्लोट. बट अगर डाउनकास्टिंग करना है तो देन यू हैव टू डू एक्सप्लिसिटली. एन एक्सप्लिसिट टाइप कन्वर्शन इज अ यूजर डिफाइंड कन्वर्शन दैट फोर्सेस एन एक्सप्रेशन टू बी अ स्पेसिफिक टाइप. अगर पर्टिकुलर स्पेसिफिक टाइप में अगर आपको कन्वर्ट करना है देन वी हैव टू गो फॉर एक्सप्लिसिट टाइप कन्वर्शन. तो देर आर टू टाइप ऑफ कन्वर्शन, वन इज इम्प्लिसिट एंड सेकेंड वन इज एक्सप्लिसिट. इम्प्लिसिटली कंपाइलर अपने आप कर लेता है. सपोज इफ यू आर हैविंग टू वैल्यूज, वन इज इंटीजर एंड वन इज फ्लोट, एंड वी आर एडिंग दैट नंबर, तो इंटीजर एंड फ्लोट आंसर विल बी फ्लोट. तो दिस इज इम्प्लिसिट कन्वर्शन. वेयर एज अगर आपको अलग से अगर कोई एक्सप्रेस करना है, एक्सप्रेशन में कन्वर्ट करना है, देन वी हैव टू यूज एक्सप्लिसिट टाइप कन्वर्शन. सी हियर, एन एक्सप्लिसिट टाइप कन्वर्शन इज अ यूजर डिफाइंड कन्वर्शन that forces an expression to be of specific type. The explicit type conversion is also known as typecasting. Typecasting is in Python performed by type function of appropriate data type. That we have already done in, I think, second or third class when we are trying to convert a string into integer. So we are using int function and float function. I think second or third class. You can go and check it out. Anyhow, let's take an example. Data type expression. Here, data type is the data type to which we want to typecast our expression. For example, b equal to 6.0. What 6.0 is what? It's a floating point number. Now you want to convert it into integer. Why? Because this is downcasting. This is not implicit. This is explicit. So we can use int function to convert this float to integer. So int b, the b will be converted into integer. We'll cast the data type of an expression as an integer. Same if you want to convert into float, you can go for float. So this is how typecasting is done in Python using a type function. Type function, type can be int, char, float. You go and check it out how many types of functions are there, that according to the requirement we can use them. So this is how this logical operator, relational operator, arithmetic operators are solved. Go through the rules. If any doubt, you can ask me. Try it out in your compiler. Two or three expressions, try to solve small programs. In one or two class we will start doing practical also. First theory part should be clear, then only we are trying to do the practical part. In next class we will use something known as, we will try to learn something known as statement flow control, or if else that we will try to do. So today we are stopping here. Any doubt you can ask me, and if you like the contents of this channel, please like, share and subscribe as much you can.